Platypuses are weird. Everything about them is bizarre, from their duck bills to their beaver tails. Like, they're technically mammals, but they're doing it all wrong. They lay eggs, they sweat out their milk, and they have venom spikes on their legs. They're just so darn different from the rest of us mammals. Well, today, I'm here to defend the poor platypus. Lots of their features might seem strange to us, but they were actually the norm for most of mammalian history. Because in the big picture of mammal evolution, platypuses aren't weird, you are. The story of mammal evolution begins over 300 million years ago with the rise of a group called synapsids. Early synapsids included things like sail-backed dimetrodon and saber-toothed gorgonopsids, who all had a lot in common with early reptiles. Eventually, those ancient synapsids gave rise to the true mammals, like you and me. Along the way, they developed classic mammalian traits like fur, milk, and warm body temperatures, plus plenty of telltale features of their skulls and jaws, which can be identified in the very oldest fossil mammals. Those first mammals lived more than 200 million years ago during the Triassic period, the beginning of the Mesozoic era, or the so-called Age of Reptiles. We typically think of mammals during the Mesozoic as being boring and unremarkable, but they were actually doing very well for themselves. There were several major mammal groups back then, including burrowers, scurriers, swimmers, and even gliders. But only three lineages of those mammals made it to today. We've got placentals, that's most of us, named for the placenta that nourishes our offspring in the womb. And then there are the marsupials, which are things like koalas, kangaroos, and our own American opossums. These guys are named for their marsupium, which is that pouch they use to carry their babies. And finally, there are the monotremes, echidnas and platypuses, the egg-laying mammals. There are a grand total of five species of those alive today, and they're all in Australia and Papua New Guinea. The word monotreme means one hole, referring to their cloaca. That's a single rear opening for all of their reproduction and bowel emptying needs, similar to what we see in reptiles. Now, placentals and marsupials are closely related to each other. These two groups split from their shared ancestors in the early Cretaceous period, around 140 million years ago. But monotremes are a more ancient branch of the mammal family tree, dating back to more than 160 million years. So while other mammals were evolving iconic features like live birth and nipples, monotremes were far along on their own separate journey, and they missed out on some of those familiar mammal traits. This doesn't make monotremes less evolved than other mammals, it just explains how they've held on to a bunch of traits that other modern mammals changed or lost over time. Which means that in many ways, monotremes are more like the ancient mammals of the Mesozoic era. They're the real OGs. And with that in mind, let's talk about some of those weird platypus traits that aren't quite as niche as they seem. Let's start with the humble egg. It's no surprise that when European scientists first got a look at platypuses, they were convinced that these bizarre mammals must be some sort of hoax. They especially didn't like the idea that platypuses laid eggs. That was just too weird for a mammal to do. In fact, for many years, some European scientists refused to believe platypuses were egg layers, even though they had eyewitness accounts from Australian settlers and, you know, the indigenous peoples that had lived with the animals for thousands of years. But those crotchety old scientists were wrong. Platypuses and echidnas do lay eggs, albeit ones that are a bit different from your average chicken egg. Instead, their shells are soft and leathery, like lizard or snake eggs. Platypuses in particular lay their eggs inside a nesting burrow. Like other egg layers, they guard the nest until the young hatch, and like other mammals, they care for their babies after they hatch. Oh, and also, baby platypuses are called puggles. This is an important fact that everybody needs to know. Puggles! Laying eggs is unusual among modern mammals, but it used to be what we all did. Those early synapsids were egg layers, and early mammals inherited that trait. That said, we're not sure exactly when modern mammals made the switch to live birth. Soft-shelled eggs don't tend to fossilize well, so we have basically no fossil record of ancient mammal reproductive habits. But based on the relationships between ancient and modern mammals, live birth seems to have shown up along the lineage leading leading to placentals and marsupials. Outside of that branch of the family tree, most ancient mammals probably laid eggs. So in that regard, platypuses are sticking to a time-honored mammal tradition. It's really us and our shell-less babies who are the reproductive renegades. Speaking of baby mammals, another unusual habit of platypuses is how they feed their young. Mammals feed their babies with milk from our special mammary glands. That's where we get the name. And milk is one of the defining features of mammals. It's full of nutrition and antimicrobial proteins that help our babies develop properly. Most modern mammals, whether they're humans or cows or kangaroos, deliver their milk using the same anatomical feature, nipples. Baby mammals can easily latch on to these built-in nozzles and drink their fill. But once again, monotremes are weird. Platypuses and echidnas produce milk, but they have no nipples. Instead, they have a flat patch of skin on their underside called an areola that just sort of leaks the milk. And yeah, placental mammals have areolas too, but they're not the leaky variety. It works a lot like sweat glands. Platypuses basically sweat out their milk, and then their little puggles lick it up. This feeding strategy seems really inefficient compared to the streamlined delivery system of nipples, but the platypus strategy actually has deep evolutionary roots. The ability to produce milk probably goes all the way back to the very first mammals. Not only do all living mammals do it, but some of the earliest fossil mammals show evidence that their young were able to grow really quickly, which would be expected if they were getting a maternal nutrient boost. Of course, the fossil record is severely lacking in nipples, so it's hard to know for sure if ancient mammals had them. But there's reason to suspect they didn't, and it brings us back to their eggs. See, the downside to soft-shelled eggs is that they can dry out easily. Lots of modern lizards and snakes have to bury their eggs in soil to keep them damp. Some scientists have hypothesized that early mammals not only used milk to feed their offspring, but also to dampen their eggs. Modern amphibians have a similar strategy. Frog and salamander parents often stick close to their eggs, and their skin secretions are thought to help keep the eggs moist. Now, we don't know for sure if platypuses soak their eggs with milk, but some research has found that monotreme milk contains certain proteins that are more typically found as important components of eggs. This supports the idea that a monotreme's milk might play a role in maintaining the health of their eggs. And while nipples are great for feeding milk into mouths, a milky skin patch is better for spreading milk over a whole nest of eggs. So the platypus strategy of puggle-pacifying perspiration might actually be just as beneficial for their developing young as a precision delivery nipple is for ours. Which also means that this strategy might have been common among those ancient egg-laying mammals. But before we get to our next platypus superpower, all research needs funding, so here's ours. This SciShow video is supported by sendacake.com, the unique gifting experience for Father's Day, birthdays, or anything else you're celebrating. Sendacake sent us the 3-layer for him explosion box, loaded with paper butterflies that fly out and a little something sweet, because that's probably what Dad really wants for Father's Day. Just let him eat his mini cake in peace. And it's also customizable, so you can upload lots of silly photos of him with the family that will be included in the For Him box. And if you're thinking that the holiday is coming up way too fast because you completely forgot when Father's Day is, and there's no way something this extravagant would get to him in time, don't worry, because Sendacake ships fast. If you know a dad anywhere in the US, you can send them this memorable Father's Day gift for 10% off using the code SciShow10 at sendacake.com. So, we've covered milk, but let's talk about another bodily secretion. Venom. Platypuses are venomous. If you ever get the chance to pick up a platypus, especially an adult male, you should really be careful around their hind legs. On each ankle, they have a sharp spur attached to a venom gland. I feel like we don't talk about this enough. Platypuses have venom spikes. These little weapons are mainly used for settling mating disputes. During the mating season, these venom glands become extra active, and male platypuses are often found with puncture wounds and even partial paralysis from the spurs of their rivals. Of course, they'll use these built-in weapons against other species too. There are plenty of reports of humans and hunting dogs ending up on the wrong end of a pair of platypus spurs. The venom isn't deadly to humans, and usually not to dogs either, although it is apparently very painful. Venom is common among groups like reptiles, insects, and fish, but it's much more unusual in mammals, and venomous ankle spurs are almost unheard of. Like, echidnas do have ankle spurs, but they aren't venomous. Which might lead you to think that these have to be a brand new platypus thing. But you would be wrong. We've found lots of ancient mammals with fossilized ankle spurs. This includes several species from the Cretaceous period, meaning they're over 66 million years old. And what's even wilder is that these Cretaceous mammals weren't just on the monotreme line, which tells us that a lot of earlier mammals had the cool ankle gear. The spurs all seem to be the same structure, so there's a really good chance they were inherited from common ancestors. And with spurs known from so many disparate parts of the mammal family tree, those ancestors must have been among the earliest mammals. So while they're weird today, ankle spurs were apparently quite common among Mesozoic mammals, and might even have been the norm. If you could travel back to the age of dinosaurs, you might witness a whole variety of macho male mammals kicking at each other with their leg spikes. Now, whether these ancient spurs were venomous is hard to say. Like soft-shelled eggs and nipples, venom glands don't tend to fossilize. But it's totally possible that venom was another common trait in those Mesozoic mammals. So just to be safe, if you do travel back to the age of dinosaurs, don't go grabbing any mammals by the feet. At this point, it should be pretty clear that a lot of the weird features of platypuses aren't quite so strange after all. But I don't want you to get the wrong idea. Platypuses are still kind of weird. Not every ancient mammal was exactly like a platypus, and they have plenty of their own unusual features, especially on their faces. Which brings us to the elephant in the room, or the duck bill, I guess? That duck-like bill isn't just for show. Platypuses use it to find food. They swim around on the bottom of muddy lakes and streams with their eyes closed, waving their bill back and forth, using electrosensitive organs in their snout to pick up signals from invertebrate prey. And when they find and slurp up that prey, they don't sink their teeth in, because the adults don't have any. Instead, they have tough pads in their jaws that they use to grind up their food. All of this is pretty unusual, even among ancient mammals. Most fossil mammal species had teeth, and they generally didn't have bills like platypuses. But what's really cool is that modern platypuses are weird, even compared to their own ancestors. Obdurodon is an ancient platypus from the Miocene that lived about 5 million years ago in what's now Australia. And their faces are similar to modern platypuses, with a bill-like structure and even evidence of nerve passages similar to the ones that power the electrosensitive organs of their living cousins. But unlike their descendants, adult Obdurodon did have teeth, and their electrosensing nerve pathways seem to be less well-developed than in modern platypuses. And what's really cool is that there's a similar nerve structure found in a bunch of other fossil monotremes too. So the ability to sense electrical signals from prey is another thing that might have been more common among ancient mammal lineages like the monotremes. But modern platypuses seem to be more electrosensitive than even their own direct ancestors, and they're definitely less toothy and more duck-facey than most ancient mammals. So yes, platypuses are a bit weird, but a lot of those traits were once standard. Things like live birth and nipples may be typical mammal stuff today, but they came about pretty recently. Before that, the world was full of egg-laying, milk-sweating, electro-sensing, ankle-spiked little furballs. Which kind of makes us the mammalian oddballs, not the platypus. So stop judging, okay?